Both pirate teams on the hardwood lost close matchups at home. But in this young season, both teams showed some resiliency, turning things around and winning big on the road. As both the men's and women's basketball teams prepare to travel out to the Bahamas, my panel and I will discuss what the Pirates need to do to continue their great starts to the season. I'm Christian Gardner, and this is Hall Talk. Welcome back to Hall Talk. I'm now joined by my panel, Liam Plate, and making her Hall Talk debut, Veronica Gail. How we doing, y'all?
Doing good. Ready to talk some Seton Hall basketball.
Very excited. My first time sitting at this desk, so hopefully it's a good time.
All right, we're going to jump right into it. On the men's side, they took on Michigan State and lost real close, but immediately was able, on that next Sunday and the next time out against St. Louis, to come out and win big. How were they able to be so efficient? Liam, we'll start with you.
I think the biggest thing for them was their free throw percentage. They shot 80% from the line. I think if you're getting that kind of production from the entire team, it will really help out in big games where they fell short like Michigan State. But then I think it says a lot about how far this team has grown, saying that they lost to St. Louis at home last season. So they've improved a whole bunch, and free throw percentage is a big part of that.
Veronica?
I would also like to mention the free throw percentage, the 80%. That is actually their season high percentage thus far, so good for the Pirates. And also, I'd like to point out that the 40% field goals in the game, that percentage, definitely helped the Pirates win.
Yeah, they're shooting so well, scoring 83 points in that matchup. And moving over to that, the offensive side of things for the Pirates, it's always been a question as to who could be that second scorer. And what we saw against St. Louis, we had three Pirates players going into double figures in Miles Powell, Quincy McKnight, and Mamu Kelishvili. For this team, who do you think could kind of be that Batman to the Robin? For a quick analogy, who could be that second scorer for the Pirates? Veronica?
I picked Mamu just because looking at the stats, he is just scoring higher than Quincy. In the St. Louis game, he scored 17 points when Quincy only scored 12. In the Michigan game, he scored 9 points and Quincy only scored 4. So for that reason, Mamu is my pick.
Liam?
I always thought it would be Miles Kale, because last season he always stepped up big. I mean, look at the Kentucky game. He hit that game-winning shot. So I always thought it would be him, but then looking at those two between Mamu and McKnight, I'm going to have to go with McKnight just because I think he's a more well-rounded player both on the defensive side of the ball and on the offensive side of the ball. I mean, he's stepped up big, and then Mamu, he did score a good amount of points so far this season, but he has been a little inconsistent from the start, especially from that Wagner and Stony Brook game, where Stony Brook, he stepped up big in the first half, but then fell off in the second. So I do think he has been a little inconsistent, but then I do think McKnight's just a more complete and smarter basketball player, which will help the Pirates in the end.
Well, I'm glad that you brought up Mamu Kelishvili. I feel like you've said it in the past, Liam, how he's a big X factor for this team. How if he's having a good night, a double-double night that we've seen that he can have, the Pirates have a big win. Now, moving into this weekend, they're taking on Florida A&M, who is 0-4. So even though it's a lesser team, who do you think needs to have a big win? Veronica?
I said Rhoda needs to have a good game. Mainly, he is a sophomore, so the younger guys, they need to start stepping up more, especially as the older guys, when we get later in the season, the older guys are going to leave. So it's really nice to see them stepping up. And also, he leads on the second group off the bench, so really would like to see him having a good game.
I have to go with Miles Kale. I said he was the guy, second guy for them last season. He has not been showing up at all this season. I mean, he had 12 points against Michigan State. So if he can do that against a big, good team like that, I don't see why he can't step up against a team like Florida A&M. I just think he needs to have a good game. He needs to score double digits. He only had 7 against St. Louis. But I just think he needs to get going, especially for this Bahamas tournament.
Oh, I'm glad that you said that. But before we go into that, what are we thinking over-under for Miles Powell in this this young season? He's just been lethal, living up to that preseason All-American record. Do you think he has over-under 25 points? Liam?
It's a little tough to judge because you're not exactly sure how Willard will play Powell, because I do expect this game to be a blowout, and we saw that in games like Wagner. Powell didn't play the whole game, so I do. It's tough for me to say. I don't know if I can really pick one. I think it'll be around 25. I guess like to pick one, just like maybe like under. I'll go under. Like maybe I'll have like 23, 24, like around the 25 range, but I wouldn't be surprised if he goes over.
What about you?
I picked over. He's yet to score under 25 points this season, so why start now? You know, keep him on the upswing. So I'd like to see over 25.
Exactly. He's trying to keep that momentum moving into that Atlantis battle for Atlantis tournament. Now, moving into that, the Pirates could take on three top-ranked teams in all of college basketball. They'll take on Oregon on Wednesday and possibly number 8 Gonzaga and maybe in the future number 5 UNC. How can they be successful in this tournament, hopefully pulling out a couple wins? Liam?
Honestly, they just need to be playing their best basketball of the season. I mean, this is another opportunity for this Pirates team to show that they're for real. They proved that last Thursday against Michigan State, and then this is just another chance for them. So I really do think what they struggled with in that Michigan State game, like we talked about in our post game, that their rotations were off on defense. They did a great job stopping the fast break, but then once they got the defense, their communication was off. They weren't rotating to the right spots. They weren't in help defense, so their communication has to be on point. They need to be able to play smart defense and able to get in those rotations and just have each other's backs out on the defensive side of the floor.
Veronica?
I think it's really, since they are ranked lower, they really got to be aggressive in this game, really giving it their all. As Liam said, they have to play their best basketball. That's really what it comes down to, playing the game, heads in the game, High School Musical style, and just playing their all, putting it all on the court. Just because they're the underdog, you know, they got to prove themselves in a way.
Well, really quick, what do you think their record will be? Do they pick up a couple wins down in the Bahamas? Veronica?
I see us beating Oregon, and I think against Gonzaga it's going to be close, but I think we're going to lose.
I can see this team going 2-1. I mean, each team's guaranteed 3 games. So I think they'll win 2 of them. I think they'll be able to compete down there. They'll show the country that, hey, we deserve to be higher ranked than 13th. So I think they'll play well, so 2-1.
Most definitely. We'll see how things work out for the Pirates out in the Bahamas. But now we're going to move over to women's basketball. A very similar record. They're 3-1 right now. They lost a close game to Princeton on Friday night, but then immediately coming back and taking on St. Joseph's and winning 55-39. Once again, how were they able to pull out this win and being so significant against St. Joseph? Veronica?
Well, definitely Desiree Elmore's 16 points definitely really helped the Pirates. And I'd also like to point out St. Joe's scored 0 from behind the arc. I think that really helped. The defense was really on that. So that's definitely a stat that stood out to me in this game.
I'd have to say the points in the paint. I mean, they had 30. And without Shadeen Samuels in the game, I think that's huge, especially Desiree Elmore stepping up, but they need without Shadeen Samuels, they needed that production. They needed the front court players to step up. They needed them to get production underneath, and hey, they came up big. They did their job.
Most definitely. I'm glad that you brought up Desiree Elmore and Shadeen Samuels. So far in this season, the Pirates have had a very balanced attack, and Shadeen Samuels went down against Princeton very early in that game, but the Pirates have still been able to be effective on offense with so many different players being able to create for themselves. Now, you brought up Desiree Elmore. Liam, who do you think that is a great scorer for this Pirates in that balanced attack?
I'd have to say Alexis Lewis. I mean, she started out the season a little slow. She's a transfer guard. She's from Iona, so she really didn't know what was like. She was feeling things out in the Big East, coming from a mid-major conference. But then against Princeton, Shadeen Samuels goes down, and then she scores 27 points, and then 12 points against the Hawks from St. Joe's. But then especially, like, she just stands out to me because I think it's great to see how far she's come, and they needed her to step up big, and she did.
Veronica?
I mean, I brought up Elmore again. She is stepping up, I feel like, as a lead scorer, 16 points last game, so I really see her on the rise, taking that spot from Samuels while she's injured.
Yeah, Elmore has just been lethal so far this season, been able to create for herself and has led scorers many times out for the Pirates. But I also like to shout out Barbara Johnson. I mean, she was a transfer coming in from Ole Miss, and this is her first real season with the Pirates and has done well and had 20 points against Princeton, and I think she can be a very good guard for the Pirates moving forward. But moving into this weekend, they're going on the road, taking on Lehigh, who's 4-0. What's your prediction for this game? Veronica, we'll start with you.
I see Seton Hall win. I feel like Lehigh, they're not really anything special to me. They're an average team. I really think Seton Hall has a good shot to win this one.
Liam?
Yeah, I have to agree with Veronica. I don't see Lehigh being anything too great. I mean, yes, they're 4-0 so far this season, but then if you look at their schedule, they've played 4 mid-major conference teams, no one from a Power 5 conference, so I do think they'll get the win. I think it'll be like 10 or 15 points Seton Hall will win. Lehigh's numbers are pretty average. I mean, I think Seton Hall has a little bit better numbers, but I do think it's going to be a Pirate win.
Now, who do you see leading the scoring since there's such a variety of scorers on this team? Liam?
I'd have to go with, it has to be Lewis or Johnson. Their guards need to step up this game because Lehigh, they are a bigger team. They have three or four players over 6 foot. So especially with Shadeen Samuels out, they do need to step up their guards. They need to beat them from the outside, from behind the three-point line. So it's got to be Lewis, it's got to be Johnson, and then Maya Jackson, and then Lauren Park Lane as well.
Veronica?
I said Elmore would be the lead scorer just because she has the most points this season. I believe she scored 82 points thus far. So I really see her stepping up and being a good scorer in this game.
Elmore, once again, leading for the Pirates for Veronica Gale. Now, they're also moving out to the Bahamas. What, really quick, what do you think their record will be out in the Bahamas for themselves?
I'm going to have to go. I think it'll be 1-2. They're coming up against some tough competition. Like, they'll play Georgia Tech their first game, and then they'll play either Vanderbilt or Rutgers in their second game. So it will be tough for them. I think it'll be 1-2. I just don't know if this Pirates team is ready for this kind of competition this early in the season. But, hey, it will be good for them to get out on a neutral site and get some experience, hopefully, that they can use later in the season when it comes tournament time.
Yeah, such a young team with all these freshman guards, Maya Jackson, Lauren Park Lane, as you said. What about you, Veronica? What's their record?
I've seen them going 2-1. I really have faith in this team. I feel like they're really stepping up. I think they're working hard. So I really am excited to see what they do in the Bahamas.
Me too. I'm really excited for this team. I think they've done really well so far with such a young team and just flat out scoring. But that's going to do it this time on Hall Talk for my panel, Veronica Gale, Liam Plate. We'll see you next time.